Hello, so today we are going to have a full review of the Elephone P3000S. Okay, so as you see here, it is a really beautiful phone. Although it's quite thick at I think 10.5 millimeters. But it has really, really great features, and I really love the Nokia Z launcher that obviously I've added later. In the beginning it was sort of modified MIUI launcher, or however you want to call it. Here, as you see, it comes with Android 4.4.2, and there are really many updates very frequently coming for the phone. Overall, I really love the responsiveness of the phone. As you can see right here, it's a really fast phone overall. Although it has the MTK 6592 processor, octa-core processor, that on most phones it isn't that fast, and Snapdragon quad-core processors can win it. This phone somehow can handle it really good. The phone is just a normal phone app of Android. Here it has the S view that works with this case that was given to me by PandaWheel. Although, as you see, the touch on it doesn't work great because it has a sort of plastic cover on the case itself that makes it quite hard for the touchscreen to detect your fingers. Other than this, as you see here, let's just go to the settings and let's just show you that there is also a notification LED that can change colors, an RGB notification LED, and also you can change the S viewer cover settings, and you can change the clock to analog or just change the colors of the digital clock if that's what you want. As you see here, this is how it looks. It's a really beautiful analog clock overall. Now let's open it up, and as you see here, there is a battery that's quite small. It looks small until you know that that's a 3150 milliampere battery. That's really a lot for a phone of this size. Here it gets a micro SIM and a normal SIM, and also here is the SD card. To put it back, put the cover back, is really easy. It isn't like the Doogie Dagger or some other Chinese branded phones. It has a great touchscreen sensor, sorry for that, fingerprint sensor. And yes, sometimes it takes more than one try, but it's really great because my iPhone 5S, sometimes after really many tries, it just failed and didn't work at all. So here, let's just play some games, for example, the Angry Birds Go. And it's a really smooth phone overall. As you see, the accelerometer works really great, and I can turn the phone exactly where I want it, and it really works really great, as you can see here. And let's just continue playing a little bit. And as you see here, even with all kinds of boosts in the game, it's really fast. Here, let's play 8-pool, that on most Android devices it's really laggy. And as you see here, it has no problems at all playing the game. And it also has really great graphics and didn't lower the graphics or anything like that. Now let's go to AnTuTu. And most times it gets about 31 to 32,000 on the score. Here it scored 31,881. The device also comes rooted and it has Super User. The problem is, though, that after updating it with Play Store, it stops working. Also, as you can see here, there is the storage thing. And it installs everything only on the phone itself, even though you choose the SD card as your primary device. As you can see here that I've done it. Now let's go to the sound. And overall, the sound is really quite clear and also very loud for such a phone. Now let's turn it off and let's not speed up the turning off and turning on. And let's see the real speed of turning it off and turning it on. And I have to say, I was really impressed. It's a really fast boot up and boot down test, as you can see here. And in only a few seconds, it already opens back on completely. Now, one problem that I've seen is with the charger. As you see here, the original charger, when you connect it to the phone, it just makes the touchscreen really bad. It somehow doesn't allow you to click what you want, and as you see here, it just clicks whatever it thinks it wants. But there is an easy way to solve it, obviously, by changing the charger to another one, and then it should work just fine as it did to me. And as you see here, it just works fine without any problems after changing the stock power supply. And yeah, everything works. Now let's see a comparison to the iPhone 5S. As you see here, the iPhone 5S is 4 inches instead of 5, but both of these screens are really great. Also, as you see, it is a little thicker, the LFone, but it isn't by a lot, as the iPhone is 7.1 millimeters and the LFone is 10.5 in my opinion. So let's just see here. The design is a really, really great design. As you can see here, I've made many shots of the design, as it was a really great designed phone. Although it's in the thicker phone's size, it has a really great design that makes it feel comfortable in the hand, even though it's a thicker device. As you see here, in direct sunlight, or not really direct, but as you see here, and here the screen works great in sun, although the camera didn't really get it, and especially obviously without any sun or much light, it should go great too. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Obviously, don't forget to like if you liked this video, as it took about 2 weeks to film all that. And also comment down below any questions you have about this phone, technology, or really anything. And subscribe to see more of my videos, as there are more such videos coming soon. Anyway, that's it for today. Bye.